So this video is for anyone that eats at restaurants ever. I have been working in the restaurant industry for the last 15 to 20 years of my life. I've worked in the front of the house, I've worked in the back of the house, and I've worked at many, many different restaurants. So this video is kind of like a reckoning, in my opinion, on behalf of people who work in restaurants, to people who like to go to restaurants. I want people watching this video to go into it with the mindset of not being offended or feeling like they're being personally attacked, because I'm not going to personally attack anyone. I'm just going to provide examples to back up my points. So I'm going to start with the back of the house. Before I even say anything else, restaurants and the people who work at them are people. They're people with families, they're people with kids, they're people that have other things to do than to be at that restaurant. It is just a job for most people who work at a restaurant. And if anything, it's not even that high of a paying job. And I'm saying that because there are a lot of people who I feel like to go to a restaurant and then take out whatever personal frustrations or grievances that they have had in their life onto their server or the manager or whoever cooked the food. And so those are the people that I really want paying the most attention to this. So I'm going to start with some basic stuff, and I'm going to start with the back of the house, the people who wash all the dishes, cook all the food, prep all the food. These are the people you don't ever see when you go into a restaurant, but trust me, there are a lot of us back there. So we know your little tricks, okay? First of all, any restaurant, when they make something like French fries, most restaurants will cook a batch of French fries and then they will sit in a container, a heated container, for usually no longer than maybe up to 10 to at the most 15 minutes. Most places will get rid of, you know, old French fries. But restaurants do it that way because it doesn't make any sense, and most places don't have the frying capacity to cook individual orders of French fries. And so one of the tricks that people like to do is they will put in an order for something and they will ask for crispy French fries or French fries with no salt. So we all know that if we get a ticket at a restaurant and they order French fries and the ticket says no salt, every cook on that line knows that all you want is a freshly cooked batch of French fries. And so you use this bullshit excuse by saying you don't want salt when you really just want freshly cooked French fries just for you in a busy ass restaurant. Because we also know that as soon as you get your French fries, you're gonna dump salt all over them at the table. So nobody eats French fries without salt. That's insane. And essentially the same thing goes for extra crispy fries. You just want brand new made fries just for you because you're really entitled. Another thing that's frustrating is when people come in and they're all pilled by this whole gluten allergy thing. Let me tell you about every restaurant. Every restaurant has gluten everywhere. So you most likely don't have a gluten allergy, because if you had celiac disease, you would not be eating at normal restaurants because you would know what it does to you. You're just being pretentious, and you probably, if anything, much more than a gluten allergy, are suffering from hypochondria. Again, every restaurant does not revolve around you. You're paying the same amount of money for the same exact thing that everyone around you is also happy to pay for, except for some reason you want brand new French fries. No place does that, not even McDonald's. McDonald's cooks a batch of fries and then keeps them in a heated thing until it's time to put them in a bag and serve them. And I'm pretty sure, according to most people, those are the best fries on the planet. Another trick that we all know you do is when someone sends their food back, but they've eaten half of it. This one is especially frustrating because of how absolutely bold it is. The audacity it takes for someone to eat half their food and then call over their server and be like, "Oh, there's something wrong with this. I think I'm gonna need a new one or a refund." You know what's happening in the back of the house when that server comes back and explains to everybody else what just happened? We are all talking absolute shit about you and cursing the day that you were born. What that is essentially a form of theft of two kinds. It's theft of the fact that you're now forcing someone to pay you something that you lied about, and you're also stealing the time of not only the server, but the staff who then has to remake a thing on the fly because you decided to be a dishonest piece of shit. Sometimes mistakes happen, and anybody who looks at their plate maybe takes a bite of something and goes, this isn't what I ordered, and you're legitimately right, and you call a server over and you say, I'm so sorry to do this. I actually ordered this way, and I didn't get it that way. As you can see, I didn't get it that way, but I also didn't eat half of it. That server's always going to come back and be like, hey, you cooks, you guys screwed this one up. And the cooks are going to go, oh shit, my bad. And we're going to fix it, and we're going to make it right for you. So, another thing. When large groups of people think it's just perfectly okay and normal to, on the busiest nights of the week, like say for example, a Friday or a Saturday night, which is when pretty much all restaurants are the busiest, and you decide you're going to get a huge group of your friends together, and you're all going to go to this one place and expect to be immediately seated and served and get the best service ever, and then find some excuse to complain about the service so that way you can justify leaving a crappy tip when your asshole decision screwed up the whole restaurant. Yeah, we all hate that. We all hate that. If you actually gave a crap, you call a place and you say, here's our plan. We want to come in and we want to do this and we would like these things. What's available? And then you, being a normal human being, listen to the response, because again, the people that work at a restaurant are just humans having to organize a bunch of other people, okay? And then you make a plan to come to that restaurant at the proper time, not an hour late or an hour early. You will get much better service. You will get much better service. And then there's the people that know for a fact that a restaurant or a place closes at a certain time. And they will not give a crap about walking in there 5 minutes before that place closes and ordering anything off the menu as if they're going to be open for the next 4 hours. Again, the people that work at restaurants are people. They're expecting that they get to go home soon. But because of your split decision in a moment to go do something, or the fact that you didn't plan your day better, and you basically just walk in and go, hey, I really want to eat the food here, and I'm too lazy to make food myself or to plan better, so I'm just going to say, screw all of you, make me my food. Because that's essentially what you're doing. And that applies even when you do it at places like Carl's Jr., McDonald's, fast food places. Those are all still people that have families, and you just walk in and you don't even understand the amount of process that you screw up when you do that. Because the way it works at a restaurant, people are pre-closing. Yes, the restaurant may be open till that time, but you're still an asshole if you're like, oh, they're technically open for another 58 seconds. I'm gonna get in there and order drinks and appetizers and an entree and dessert. You're the worst type of person if you do that. It says so much about you. It says you don't give a crap about anything but yourself. And everyone in the restaurant, everyone hates you. And I wanna make it clear, this is not about any single one restaurant. This is the case in every single restaurant that I've worked at in Shasta County. Another thing, this one is to the men. Stop hitting on your servers, you frickin' weirdos. Keep your goddamn mouth shut, because this is still a human being. And you don't then just get to go express the fact that you're some horny old piece of shit to this young female just trying to do her job at most likely a minimum wage position. And now she has to deal with sexual harassment from someone she can't stand up to, because that could affect her bottom line and she might not get tips and not be able to pay her bills. It's very predatory. And it sucks. And to the women, when the female server that's helping your table at a restaurant is prettier than you, you do not then get to act like the alpha and start pretending to be some sort of domineering person over the situation because you're trying to flex to your man or the people around you that you don't care that the server is obviously way more attractive than you are. That's a moment of insecurity for you, and again, you're doing nothing but making a stranger who's trying to do her job feel weird. I could probably keep going, but this is already a long video. The point is that for way too long, so many people have treated restaurant employees like absolute shit. They have taken their own personal problems out on them because they feel like, well, I can take it out on this server or this manager at a restaurant because they can't do anything to me. But I'm really mad about the fact that someone treated me like shit earlier today, so I'm making shit roll downhill and I'm taking it on this service worker. Stop doing that. Because I'll tell you this, shit changed after COVID. It is way harder to find good people that even want to work in a restaurant anymore. So those of us that are left, it's much more difficult for us to put up with your bullshit. So unless you people want to learn how to cook better or be forced to deal with going to restaurants where all of their employees and their cooks and everybody suck at their job because they can't get good help, maybe stop being such a piece of shit to the people that create and serve you your food.
Hey there, ladies.
Amy's busy, so I thought I'd bring your food out for you.
But I still have some salad left.
Oh, well, would you like me to take the food back and bring it out in a few minutes?
Yeah, and let it dry out under the heat lamps. Just give me the food.
There you go.
Wait. Did that waitress listen to a word I said? This steak is medium rare. I asked for it medium, and I wanted extra gravy on my mashed potatoes. Let me ask you something. How hard is your job? How intelligent do you have to be to take a food order? Jesus!
Ma'am, you're absolutely right, and I apologize. I'm gonna get this fixed for you right away.